Dear friends, good morning. I warmly welcome you all on this opening day of Pulse's Conclave 2020. This is the fifth edition of the Conclave and is being eagerly looked forward by the trade stakeholders. I welcome Mr. David Merritt, Honorable Minister of Agriculture of Saskatchewan, Canada, Mr. Rick Burton, Deputy Minister of Agriculture, Government of Saskatchewan, Canada. As we all know, Canada has been the long trading partner of India in the pulses trade. Special thanks to Madam Cindy Brown, President of Pulses Global Pulses Confederation. The presence of dignitaries marked the importance of pulses trade in India, and India as a major player in the global pulses trade. I am also heartened to see a large number of international guests who have come from various parts of the world despite a recent travel scare on account of coronavirus. Thank you all. India, as we all know, has a unique distinction between the largest producer, consumer, and importer of pulses in the world. In India, the pulses are cultivated on approximately 25 million hectares. India, however, finds itself in a short of pulses due to low average yield on production side and a large consumption, with the pulses being the main sources of protein. Between 2013 and 2016, India's annual pulses production varied between 16 million tons to 19 million tons, necessitating imports in the range of 3.5 million tons to 6 million tons. During 2015-16, pulses production fell to 16 million tons against the consumption of 23 million tons. This led to a record import of 5.57 million tons. Since then, the Government of India has taken a concerted measure of increasing the minimum support price, procurement by the government agency to create a buffer stock, and increase in the import duty, which have yielded a positive result. Area under pulses cultivation has expanded. Production in recent years have reached 23 million tons. Imports dropped to 2 to 2.5 million tons. Having said this, fact remains that much of the pulses production in India is rain-fed and hence the subject to weather vagaries. Frequent short supplies of pulses of a particular kind and consequent price spurt cannot be ruled out. We have already experienced this in the recent case in Uda, that is black mud pea and mung beans. It is therefore important that government policies strike balance between farmers and consumer interests, and actions are flexible enough to react on the ground reality swiftly. We are pleased that IPG has earned recognition and respect from the government and gets attentive ears of our decision makers. We'll continue to engage with the key ministries to discuss the various initiatives to devise and implement pragmatic programs. As for our international friends, we do realize difficulty faced by them when, as the largest importer country, curtails the import by more than 50% within a short span of couple of years. However, as we all are aware that today's world order, we have seen such happening with other commodities in different parts of the world, and we'll have to live up to the changing the trade balances. In this conclave, with concentrating on India's and global pulses scenario, we have interesting presentation focusing on pulses research in India, health benefit of pulses, production innovation, etc. I sincerely wish for an active participation from all of you. Please feel free to ask questions and express your views in the time given after each session. Lastly, on behalf of IPGA and pulses trade in India, I assure the government that we are with you in your endeavor and increase the pulses production by improved farm practices and yield enhancement, and doubling the farmer income by 2020. I am sure besides attending the conclave, in your spare time, you will venture out to explore this beautiful venue in a picturesque valley rested in the Sayadri Mountains range and make the event fruitful and memorable. Enjoy your conclave, enjoy your stay. Thank you.